Close. Adam Vingan lays out what fans need to watch for when the Nashville Predators in Game 4 try to keep the Colorado Avalanche at bay. Nashville's Mike Fisher had the puck. Colorado's Gabriel Landeskog took it. Nashville's other four skaters drifted helplessly. Colorado's Nathan MacKinnon went in for the knockout. MacKinnon, fed deftly by Landeskog, was all alone to beat Pekka Rinne, a mismatch on a night of them. And in that swooping finish he took Pepsi Center back to the good old days and this series to a new place. More, Predators, catfish tradition continues in Colorado. Return of catfish Jake. The Stanley Cup playoffs can thrill, create stars and bring existing stars to greater heights. And they can surprise. Most of the hockey world that unanimously picked the Cup favorite Predators to win this series gave the Avalanche a game. So maybe Monday's 5-3 Colorado win is just that, the one game the young AVs are going to get before the Predators drop the hammer and move on to bigger challenges. But when you actually see that game happen, you have to consider it as part of the whole. And the truth through three games is that Colorado has been their stride for stride a better, with a few gaffes, and resulting Predators pounces, that cost the Avalanche twice at Bridgestone Arena. Now that we've seen the AVs take a game, with the quickest 1-0 lead yet of the three, with the Predators bumbling about in embarrassing fashion for the entire first period, with MacKinnon continuing to show why he might be this league's MVP, how can Wednesday's attempt at a series equalizer in the same rocking building be dismissed as unlikely? More, Predators making a habit of falling behind early against Avalanche in Stanley Cup playoffs. In my opinion, we've been a better team 5-on-5, Colorado coach Jared Bednar said after the teams followed up 14 combined penalties in Game 3 with 13 in Game 4, the Predators taking most of their 7 because of frustration and defensive inadequacy are both. There's a tremendous hockey team across from us, Ryan Johansson said after scoring one of Nashville's 3 goals to help make the final score look better. It doesn't matter who you play in our league, that's the beauty of it. If you're not on your best, you'll lose, even without starting goalie Semyon Varlamov and defensive aces Eric Johnson and Samuel Girard. Colorado is 60 comparable minutes away from establishing a brand new, 3-game series with all pressure on the Predators. More, Predators preach improvement despite playoff series lead against Avalanche and the Predators can't let that happen. They have to be better than this. This was 25 minutes of garbage creating 35 minutes of garbage time. Another turnover led to MacKinnon's second goal and a 4-0 lead with 15:35 left in the second period, and that was it for Rinne. He gave up 4 goals on 15 shots, and there will be plenty of freaking out about his play, but please understand, he had no chance. His teammates treated him to a torching, we just weren't very good in front of him. I didn't think we were giving him the support he needed, Predators coach Peter Laviolette said of the decision to send in Juuse Saros, who played well in relief. Obviously we gave up some grade A chances right in front of Pecs, Colton Sissons said, and hung him out to dry with some pretty talented players. The Predators can't have Roman Josi and Ryan Ellis failing to clear and failing to cover while Philip Forsberg is beat to the net less than 2 minutes into the game. They can't be this slow to pucks, or lose this many puck battles when they arrive in time. They can't have PK Subban losing his mind and punching MacKinnon in the back of the head. They can't wait until garbage time to start playing. They have a lot of team speed and they were just faster and more competitive than us in the first period, Johansson said. Obviously if that's the case, they're going to score some goals and get a lead. They gained a lot of momentum, used their atmosphere to their advantage and we weren't able to respond in that first period. That can happen. It's time, in Wednesday's Game 4, to see the team that won the President's Trophy and established itself as the one to beat in these playoffs. More, Predators pounded early, dominated by Avalanche in Game 3 lost. The Predators would never talk about anything other than that, the next game, but we can. Everyone knows what's next if the Predators and Winnipeg Jets don't blow their 2-0 series starts, a second-round meeting that would be worthy of a Stanley Cup final. And neither side wants to be at a distinct rest disadvantage. The Jets lost 6-2 on Sunday at Minnesota and face their own pivotal moment Tuesday against the Wild. They were awful in Game 3. The Predators were awful in their own Game 3. They will sneak subtle glances at each other over the next 2 nights. Eventually they should meet. Boston and Tampa Bay also had 2-0 leads in their series entering Monday and took road beatings from Toronto and New Jersey, respectively. It happens. Close. Ultimate Predator started the first Let's Go Predators chant at the Bridgestone Arena watch party for Game 3. But the Predators are going to have to earn this. These Avalanche aren't nearly in the realm of the teams that brought two Stanley Cups to Denver and contended for more with great players Joe Sakic, Peter Forsberg, repugnant villains Claude Lemieux and mixtures of both Patrick Roy. But Sakic, the GM, has put together a fast, a young group that just matched the fourth-best regular season turnaround in NHL history, and just thumped the Stanley Cup favorite in a playoff game. The AVs must be taken seriously. There's no indication the Predators have failed to do so. Laviolette grumbled before flying to Denver about media not giving the Avalanche enough respect, but that's not true either. Close fans at the Bridgestone Arena started chanting "We want the Cup" during the first period of Game 3 between Nashville and the Colorado Avalanche. The hockey world expected this series to be quick and easy because of how much respect it has for the Nashville Predators. That's all. They earned it with a consistently excellent regular on the heels of a Stanley Cup final run, and it's time for them to prove everyone right. It's time to be the team of the past 6 months, a team that stinks to this degree only on rare occasions, and always cleans up right afterward. Reach Joe Rexroad at jrexroad@tennessean.com and follow him on Twitter at joerexroad.